The big story this noon, presidential address to America's school children. You're looking live at Wakefield High School in Arlington, Virginia. This is where any minute now President Obama is set to take the stage in a speech to America's children. Good afternoon. I'm Stephen Holt. That speech has sparked controversy around the country, with many schools actually refusing to air it, saying President Obama is using this time to push his political agenda. Of course, we'll have reaction from schools in our area coming up. But first, let's take a look back at Wakefield High School. That's where the president any minute now is expected to get on the stage and talk to high school students there, as well as high school students and elementary school students across the country. Now, the key to this, many people in the White House saying this is a speech about education, talking about staying in school, staying committed to goals and dreams. At the same time, others fearing that it could be a platform for the president's agenda. Also, one of the key issues there is talking about the health care debate, one that's very heated here in this country at this time. Again, the president expected to come and make his speech here. We're going to go live to Meredith McDonough, who's outside a local school here in Palm Beach County, where many students will be listening to this speech. And Meredith, can you tell us, at the school that you're at, are students going to be watching this speech live?
Actually, Stephen, here at Palm Beach Gardens Elementary School, the principal and teachers have decided to tape the speech instead of airing it live, all to give parents an option.
Morning. I don't think it's going to make the kids do any better than what they're doing now. I think they're going to work just as hard as they always have. But like I said, I left it up to my children.
Tanya Florenko, along with other parents, dropping their kids off at Palm Beach Gardens Elementary. Part of the curriculum today, nationwide, President Obama's speech to students.
I kind of think it's going to be a waste of time pulling the kids out of class for the president to say do well in school when they should be in class doing well in school.
But this school chose not to air the president's speech live.
We had calls and inquiries from parents about whether or not we were showing the speech. So we just want to give them the option of either watching President Obama's message or allowing the children to sit out of that message.
Some parents feel the controversy surrounding this speech has gone too far, especially if the president is encouraging students to work hard in the classroom.
I think that he is the president, so I think they have a right to hear him speak. I don't think it's about politics. I think he's just talking to the kids, and I don't think there's any reason to make such a fuss over it.
The school plans on airing the speech later this week. However, if any parents object, their kids don't have to watch it. Live in Palm Beach Gardens, Meredith McDonough, WPBF News 25.
All right, Meredith. Now, in Martin County, schools are airing this address live, but they have alternate activities set up for kids whose parents don't want them to see it. That has been the case with many families here in our area. Okeechobee County will be recording the address, then decide whether or not to air it to those students. Indian River County will not show the speech at all. You can, of course, read the transcript, which has been made available. It's on our website, WPBF.com. That's where you can go take a look at what the president is going to be saying here in just a little bit. We're still awaiting his arrival on the stage. Of course, we'll be going to that in just a little bit. Now, one of the president's biggest fans showed up today on the Bonnie Hunt Show.
Please welcome that journalist, 11-year-old Damon Weaver.
There he is. Damon Weaver sat down with the talk show host to talk about what it was like to interview the commander-in-chief. But when Weaver found out he snagged the history-making interview, he had less than a day to get a brand new suit and get on a plane to D.C.
I was in bed. My mom yelled to me, "Hey, little Damon! Get your behind out that bed."
Wait, I love this impersonation of your mother. She says, "What?" So your mom yells to you, what?
Get your behind out that bed.
Wow, that's pretty presidential and official.
Hunt gave Weaver a brand new laptop for being on the show. And if you want more of the interview with Mr. Weaver, that's starting at 5, we're going to tell you what prompted this man to dress up like a lunch lady and give Weaver a fresh mango. And hear all about Weaver's latest celebrity interview with Courtney Cox. You can watch the Bonnie Hunt Show every day at 10 o'clock in the morning right here on WPBF 25. The Palm Beach County Sheriff's Office is investigating a shooting that happened just down the street from their headquarters. Around 10:30 last night, an unidentified woman was shot in her car at the intersection of Gun Club and Kirk Roads. Police tell us there was a crash prior to the shooting, and it's not clear if the other driver knew her or if it was a case of road rage. She was airlifted to Delray Medical Center with life-threatening injuries. The only description of the other vehicle was that it was dark-colored. A Good Samaritan is credited with chasing down a driver responsible for a deadly hit and run in West Palm Beach. Police say Renee Angela Martin hit a man last night as he walked along Broadway near 54th Street. She drove off, but the car behind her wouldn't let her get away. The second driver called 911 and followed her until police arrived. The victim, whose name hasn't been released, was taken to St. Mary's Medical Center, where he died. We now know the name of the man killed over the weekend in Boynton Beach. Police were called to the home of 23-year-old Vladimir Valcourt early Sunday morning for reports of shots fired. When they arrived, they found Valcourt was shot to death in the middle of Old Boynton Beach Road. Police are now looking for four or five suspects, last seen fleeing the scene in two cars, a brown Jeep Cherokee and an unknown Chrysler SUV-type vehicle. If you know anything about this case, call the Palm Beach County Sheriff's Office. And while police continue to search for suspects in the murder of a Fort Pierce store owner, his friends and family gathered last night to say goodbye. As Ted White explains, he's a father, a husband, and a friend who will sorely be missed.
Outside A&M Discount Beverage, the doors remain closed. Love, pain, and heartache has stepped in. Little Elijah Blanco and his mother spent part of Labor Day paying their respects to a man whose life was taken in an instant.
He was just a very, very nice man, nice to every customer that came in here.
Later in the afternoon, a few miles down the street, Yates Funeral Home is bursting at the seams. Hundreds of people packed the building to say goodbye to Parag Patel. He was gunned down by robbers Friday morning while working inside his Fort Pierce store.
That's all prayer they're doing right now, trying to tell God, take him to good place, keep him all right.
Patel's body is here for all to see.
When I viewed Mr. Patel and I hugged his wife, I could feel her pain.
Very caring person. So he has the same business as we are. Very good person in the community too.
A Hindu priest performs last rites on Patel. His young daughters take part in the ceremony. They worship his spirit with basic food groups. Twigs will help during the cremation. Color is used to purify his soul.
Whenever we met each other, we always talked to each other, and he was really nice to everybody around him. It's a big loss to our community.
Parag Patel, husband, father, business owner, friend, gone from this world and into the next.
Ted White, WPBF News 45.